Good morning. It's good to spend a little time with you today. Yesterday, you were able to hear from Maxine Pinson, one of our church members. She is the mom to Melissa Ashbaugh and the grandmother to Celia and Ale, longtime members of the church. We'd love hearing from some of you and the way God is working in each of your lives during this time. Maxine was able to share how much her quiet time with God means to her in that special garden space that they have in that courtyard. And today's lectionary text lends itself right to what Maxine was sharing yesterday. Our lectionary text takes us to Genesis chapter 1 today, the very beginning, the creation of the world. I know that's a familiar text to you, but I want to encourage you to go back to Scripture, to Genesis 1, and reread that section of Scripture about the beginning of the world. Read it with fresh eyes. We just started a new ministry at the church for our children and our families. It's called The Bible at Bedtime. And we are reading different Bible stories each night at 8 o'clock on our Facebook Live family ministry page. And I was able to start that about a week ago with our families and read the creation story to our children as the start of that ministry. So I encourage you to do that the same. Read with fresh eyes that story of creation. The way God created the heavens and the earth and the sun and the moon and the stars, the planets, the land, the sea, every living thing, the plants, the trees, the animals that walk the earth, the fish that swim in the sea. When I think of the ecosystems that God created and the way they all are dependent on one another, you can't help but be amazed at the creation. And while the creation story might still leave questions for you, and you might wonder, well, how exactly did all of that happen? We have to just trust that there's no other answer than God created the heavens and the earth. God created all that there is. And then after he created all this amazing nature that surrounds us, God created man and woman. God created humankind in his image. How beautiful it is when we can look around at our brothers and sisters in Christ, and even if they are different from us, we can see them as children of God, because that's how we were all created, in God's image. So my encouragement for you today is to go outside and find a beautiful spot in nature. They surround us. These beautiful spaces surround us. Find a spot in nature. Have a quiet time. Thank God for the creation that surrounds you. Thank God for the creation of humankind. And just be grateful. Just sit in awe and in wonder of what surrounds you. God is so good to us, and it is such a blessing to be able to be in this beautiful space, in his beautiful creation. I hope you enjoy your quiet time today outside somewhere, giving thanks to God. Have a great day.